Lisa Briggs from the Bruce Company is here taking your calls at 270-9933. Good to see you.
Hi, Lisa. Good to see you.
All right. All the lines are full, so let's start clearing them. Let's start with Chris in DeForest. Hi, Chris. What's your question?
Hi. We have some daylilies, and they're about 3 years old, but they flower. The flowers don't get much taller than the leaves. They're pretty full, but they bloom right in the middle of the plant, and I was wondering if they what we can do to help them.
Well, there are, Chris, some smaller-sized daylilies, so it might just be that you have one of those more miniature ones like Stella Doral or Bodacious Returns. There are a bunch of them, and the flowers are not a whole lot taller than the plants themselves. If you're not getting a lot of flowers, it might be a sun issue. The more sun they get, the better they're going to flower. You could also give them some bloom-boosting fertilizer, like some, not blood meal, bone meal in the fall. That would help too.
But full sun.
Okay. Really full sun. The more sun they get, the better they'll bloom.
All right.
All right. Thanks for calling today. Let's go to Judy in Madison. Hi, Judy. What's your question?
Hi. My question is I'm wondering the best time to prune a smoke bush.
Okay, Judy. So you want to prune smoke bushes right after they're done flowering. So if you prune them too late, what you're doing is you're cutting the flowers off for the following season. So when you get those plumy, smoky flowers, when that's done, then you go ahead and take those off, and then it will be able to set flower buds for the next year.
Okay.
All right.
Let's go to Diane in Madison. Hi, Diane. What's your question? Diane, you there?
Yes.
Hi, what's your question?
I have a question about snapdragons. How do you keep them blooming? They seem to get a pod on the top and don't bloom.
So what you want to do, Diane, is as they flower from the bottom of this flower stem to the top, when they get done, you cut that flower stem off just below a pair of buds, and then you'll get new branching buds that'll come out, and then the plant will be fuller and also will keep on flowering. The other thing you want to do with annuals, though, is to fertilize. You can use Miracle-Gro or some other kind of water-soluble fertilizer or something slow-release like Osmocote. Annuals are fertilized pretty heavily at the grower, and then by the time you get them home and we get to the end of June, there's no fertilizer left.
Okay,
so
thanks
give them some
a lot.
Food.
All right,
good luck to you. Thanks for calling. Let's go to Darlene in Madison. Hi, Darlene, what's your question?
Hi, thank you. I have a Stanley plum tree, and I noticed that it has black rot on it. And I when I looked it up, it said I should wait till fall to trim it out, but it makes me nervous just having that. Should I just get rid of the tree? Should I just cut those parts out and then spray it with a fungicide? It just makes me kind of nervous waiting till fall to do that.
So when you're talking about black rot, you're talking about it's got some black growths on the stem.
Yeah, it's got some bunchy brown black on the rest of the tree looks good, but just on the branches.
Okay, so that's called black knot with a K-N-O-T.
Oh, okay.
And that is a fungus that is not treatable. The only thing you can do is prune it out, I would say back 8 or 12 inches inside the tree where the growth is healthy. The other thing you want to be careful of when you prune it is that you sterilize your pruners between every single cut with either Lysol spray or a bleach solution or some alcohol, because you can spread it from this cut to another place.
Wow. Nasty.
So black knot is very common on all kinds of prunus, cherries, plums, peaches, and once you get it, it just gets worse. So you should probably think about getting a replacement eventually, but if it's not a lot, just prune it out, but be sure to sterilize.
Wow.
Okay. I think we have time for one more call. Harold from Partyville, go ahead.
Yes, thank you. I have an asparagus patch that I've gone to seed, and all of a sudden I believe a rabbit's been chewing the tops and stuff, and I was kind of wondering if that was going to hurt asparagus for next year, or are they going to be okay?
It won't hurt them long term, Harold. You'll probably want to keep them away and from doing much damage, because as the plant is putting out that growth, it is putting in energy for next year. I would use a repellent. I really like the granular predator urine.
Well, it comes in granular now.
Yeah, it comes in granular now, which is way better than the stinky liquid, but it's super effective. That's what I've been using this year to keep the bunnies away from my hosta.
Oh, well, that's good to know.
There's a lot of bunnies. I think the coyote population might be down.
A slew of bunnies this year.
All right. Thank you all for calling in. We're out of time. Lisa, good to see you.
Good to see you. We'll do this again soon.
Absolutely.
All right. We'll be right back with a final check of your forecast.